New Edge Pro Gel, official sponsor of NFL Team Highlight Films. Edge Pro Gel will give you a shave so comfortable that no other gel or foam can beat it. For a great, comfortable shave every day, try new Edge Pro Gel. Save your skin.
In 1996, the New England Patriots earned a trip to the NFL's biggest game, the Super Bowl. And with the eyes of the world upon them, the Patriots came out fighting for every yard.
Hey, we've been getting mad for 2 weeks. Here's our chance to do something about it. Let's go. 1, 2, 3.
This young team of poise and promise put 21 points on the scoreboard, including touchdown passes from Drew Bledsoe to Keith Byers and Ben Coates.
Play action fake, Bledsoe rolling right, looking, fires, touchdown, and a touchdown!
The defense made its mark as well. The Patriots extended themselves to the limit, but despite a gallant effort, New England came up short in this one last battle. Losing Super Bowl 31, however, did nothing to diminish what this team accomplished in getting there. 1996 was no ordinary season, but one of spectacular plays, unforgettable victories, and glory achieved with nothing but guts and grit. The most prolific offense in the AFC was balanced by a relentless defensive attack. This team displayed the heart of a champion all year long, and the Patriots always stayed focused on what lay ahead. From the last man on the bench to the man at the top of the organization, the Patriots proved unwilling to stop even 1 yard short.
Fires right, caught by Jefferson, down to the 5 and out and in. Touchdown, Schultz, fires.
This team realized a dream that New England fans have had for 37 years. And the 1996 Patriots will forever be remembered for bringing a championship home. Dreams of postseason possibilities were seemingly crushed in the first 2 weeks as the Patriots got off to a disappointing start. Week one, they fell flat in Miami. And week two, they fell short in Buffalo. Where was the determination, the drive needed to take this team to the top? Week three found the Patriots at home in front of a sold-out crowd that still had faith. But the first steps on the long road to the Super Bowl had to be taken now or never. What Foxborough fans expected, the Patriots delivered. And from start to finish, this game belonged to New England. The offense was high-flying, and the defense grounded the Cardinals with a shutout. What made the difference?
We just stayed together. Everybody stayed focused. We concentrated on what we wanted to do as a team. We really knew what we wanted to do. We just had a tough time at the beginning. So I think, you know, we all pulled together and believed in one another, and we got the job done.
By the time the Patriots had finished with Arizona, New England had recorded its most decisive victory in 3 seasons. With confidence renewed, the Patriots had finally ignited their potential. And starting with Jacksonville, were ready to blaze their way through the rest of the season.
We're going to start the fire today. We're going to light the fire. Let's go, baby. Let's go, baby. Hey, 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 hey.
The Patriots were on fire in the first half and jumped out to a 22-0 lead.
4 yard line. Back to throw is Bledsoe. He looks, he fires, touchdown to Ben Coates. First and goal, it's Curtis coming to the left side on the draw. Turning it wide, and turning it in. Touchdown, Curtis Martin.
After Curtis Martin's four-yard jaunt to the end zone, the Jaguars cooled New England off by scoring on three long touchdowns and tied the game. But a fourth long play would fall just inches short and send this thriller into overtime.
And he caught it. No, caught at the goal line by Jacksonville. One yard time has run out.
It was time for kicker Adam Vinatieri to ice the game.
Let's go to the locker room.
40-yard field goal attempt by Vinatieri. The angle to the left. Two for the hole. The ball down. The kick up on the way. And it is good.
The Patriots celebrated their narrow escape, not suspecting that they would face Jacksonville again. After a week off, New England continued its winning ways, notching three victories in its next four games. The Patriots' front line in 1996 was anchored by Pro Bowler Bruce Armstrong, along with players like Max Lane, Dave Willoughby, Todd Rucci, and William Roberts. Behind these mighty men, New England reached the end zone four times against the Ravens, which seemed to erase any lingering doubts about what the offense could do.
Ever since that game, we started, executing a lot better. We started putting the ball in the end zone instead of kicking field goals, and instead of punting, we were getting the first downs we needed. So we began to gel together as an offense.
Heads up special teams play polished off the Patriots' 46-point day. After a frustrating loss to Washington, New England had little trouble in Indianapolis as Curtis Martin contributed two scores in the 27-9 victory. 1 week later, in a rematch with Buffalo, the Patriots overcame a fourth quarter deficit with two big plays.
Kelly is back to throw. Here's the rush. He's hit it. He gets the ball away. It's intercepted by McGinnis at the 40, 35. He's going to go all the way. Willie McGinnis. Patriots will win it.
Willie McGinnis' first career touchdown moved New England into a three-way tie for first in the AFC East. But two key division matchups lay ahead that would test this team's stamina. The Patriots were eager for redemption when the Dolphins came to town week 10, and New England took its revenge in dramatic style. The Patriots overcame a 17-14 deficit with 28 second-half points, including two touchdown passes from Drew Bledsoe to tight end Ben Coates.
He is back to throw, fires it right, completes to Coates at the 20, 25, breaks the tackle, 30, 35, 40, Ben Coates at midfield, Robin, he's going to catch him.
Coates' definitive 84-yard score put the game out of reach. 1 week later, it was time to see if a 21-point comeback was out of the question when the Patriots found themselves down by three scores to the Jets. Terry Glenn's 26-yard touchdown catch right before the half gave New England life, and Drew Bledsoe led the Patriots on four second-half scoring drives. Ben Coates' end zone trip tied the game, but after the Jets went up again by three, it was Keith Byers who grabbed the winning touchdown pass.
Byers, touchdown to Keith Byers. Drew Bledsoe's third touchdown pass of the game.
With New England at 7-3, fans at Foxborough were pumped up for Denver's arrival. But the Broncos quickly and decisively deflated this team with a 34-8 knockout punch. The Patriots found themselves at a crossroads.
We stunk up the joint, and I mean, it was an embarrassment to the team, you know, each individual that was out there playing. We disappointed a lot of people.
Play some defense out there! Send the cheerleaders out to play for you!
We didn't play well at all as a whole team, and I think that was really one of the changing points. After the game, everybody had to look themselves in the mirror, everyone, and say, man, if we really want to, you know, try to win this thing, we got to play better defensively.
Would the Denver loss shatter this team's confidence or strengthen its resolve? Would it deter the Patriots from their goal or infuse them with even more determination and drive? Just 1 week later against Indianapolis, the Patriots proved that one loss, no matter how embarrassing, would not derail their dream season.
Play action fake, Bledsoe, end zone, touchdown, Terry Glenn.
By taking a 17-0 lead, New England controlled this game from start to finish. While the running game had been almost absent against Denver, Curtis Martin rushed over, around, and through the Colts for 141 yards and his 16th touchdown of the season. The Patriots were back on track and marched into San Diego, where they would stage one of their greatest performances of the season.
Bledsoe to throw, looking, still looking, got time. Now throws in the end zone, touchdown, Patriots!
Offensively, New England played nearly flawless football as Drew Bledsoe threw four touchdown passes and not a single interception.
Fires right, caught by Jefferson, down to the five and out of the end. Touchdown, Sean Jefferson!
Defensively, the Patriots were just as impressive. They kept the Chargers scoreless in the final three quarters and forced six San Diego turnovers. Willie McGinnis turned one into a touchdown.
Looking up the field now, being chased. Going to be hit. Ball is fumbled. Ball is in the end zone. Ball is fumbled on. Touchdown, Patriots!
The special teams even added their own game highlight when Larry Wiggum, number 25, forced another San Diego miscue.
Being chased down the left side and is hit, fumble on the play, picked up by the Patriots down the right sideline, roaring in for a touchdown.
Corwin Brown's 42-yard fumble return capped off a 45-point day that Patriot fans from coast to coast could celebrate. In Week 15's rematch with the Jets, the defense was ready to rumble yet again and crush New York, recording two turnovers and four sacks. As the Patriots cruised to victory, Curtis Martin eclipsed the 1,000-yard mark and sailed into the end zone for a 19-yard score.
Martin coming to the right for the 15.
The defense put this game out of reach, however, when Ty Law, number 24, intercepted a pass and navigated home from 38 yards out for his first career touchdown. New England was 10-4 and playoff bound with a chance to win the division. But with two big games left on the road against Dallas and the Giants, the Patriots couldn't celebrate just yet. In 1996, the success of New England's offense began in the trenches, where Bruce Armstrong, number 78, earned his fifth Pro Bowl trip as offensive tackle. Despite his enormous contribution, Armstrong considers the Patriots' success a team effort.
We have a good offensive line. We have great receivers, best tight end in the game, one of the best running backs in the game, and the best young quarterback. I mean, it's like we were assembled to score points.
Quarterback Drew Bledsoe piloted the AFC's most prolific offense and was one of only two top guns to break the 4,000-yard passing mark. He led the league in pass completions and earned a Pro Bowl trip.
He has the knowledge, the competitiveness, and the drive to lead this team. He's just becoming a better all-around player, and he's understanding, you know, what it takes to be a leader and also to be a winner.
Bledsoe had plenty of targets to choose from, like Sean Jefferson and number 33 Sam Gash. But his favorite go-to guy for the score was tight end Ben Coates.
To the right, Ben Coates has it at the 10, at the 5, Ben Coates is in, touchdown!
Making even the most difficult of grabs, number 87 earned his third consecutive Pro Bowl trip, with 62 catches for nearly 700 yards, and led the team with 9 receiving touchdowns.
The newest addition to the Patriots' offensive attack made a huge impact in 1996.
It is caught, a diving grab by Terry Glenn, and he is in.
Terry Glenn took the NFL by storm and whipped up 1,132 receiving yards with 90 catches, shattering the NFL rookie reception record. A much-needed target for Bledsoe, Glenn proved to be much more. And in 1996, the Patriots notched a franchise first by matching their 1,000-yard receiver with a 1,000-yard rusher, Curtis Martin. Number 28 became just the 15th player in league history to eclipse the 1,000-yard plateau in each of his first 2 years. And in 96, the Pro Bowl-bound running back lit up the scoreboard with an AFC-best 17 touchdowns.
Give to Curtis Martin up the middle inside the 10. Juking inside down to the 5. Spinning outside. Turning the corner.
It would be a mistake to discount the contribution of special teams in 1996, highlighted in part by punter Tom Tupa, who averaged 43.5 yards to finish third among the Patriots' all-time single-season punting performances. Rookie kicker Adam Vinatieri played with poise under pressure, and his 120 points set a franchise record for first-year kickers. The star of the return game was Dave Meggett, who set a Patriots record for punt returns with 52 and finished with an average 11.3 return yards per punt. The defensive unit was the biggest surprise of the season and proved relentless in its attack on unsuspecting opponents. Featuring players like Chris Slade, Ted Johnson, Todd Collins, Mark Wheeler, Willie Clay, and Ty Law, the defense stuffed the run and pummeled opposing passers, especially in the last 6 games of the year when they held opponents to an average of just 10 points per game. Leading the team in sacks with 9.5 was Willie McGinnis, who also led the team by example by leaving his opponent shell-shocked. It was this unit's attitude and aptitude, talent and teamwork in the season's second half that made the difference for the Patriots.
Showdown, baby. It's a showdown. Time for somebody else to take over the throne. It's about the New England Patriots. It ain't about nobody but us.
Against the defending Super Bowl champions, the defense stepped up with one of its toughest showings of the year, sacking Troy Aikman 3 times in the first half alone. Quarterback Ty Law's 2 interceptions were key to keeping one of the league's best offenses out of the end zone. The Patriots lost the field goal battle, but they came away from Dallas with a moral victory that gave them one more reason to believe in themselves.
We realized that, you know, we can do this. You know, we're a good team. We just have to put it together.
For New England, everything seemed to come apart on their return to the Meadowlands as the Giants jumped out to a 22-0 halftime lead.
It's a tough situation being down 3 touchdowns and expect to come out and win. But the guys stayed together. We believed in one another. We stayed together. Big players made big plays, and we were able to be successful.
Out of sorts, but not out of options, New England battled back in the second half. And Dave Meggett made one of the biggest plays of the game, returning a punt 60 yards to bring the Patriots within 5. In the closing moments, Drew Bledsoe dissected the Giants and led one of the most impressive drives of his career. Troy Brown and Terry Glenn made 2 critical catches in the clutch. And with New England's last chance, Bledsoe and Ben Coates delivered the knockout punch.
Fires. Coates has it at the 1-yard line. Trying to drive it down, and he is in the end zone.
The comeback was complete, and the AFC East champions had earned a playoff bye.
The win, making key plays when we had to, showed us that we had something special here. I think that was kind of a defining moment for us.
Actually, the fair was closer to pea soup as a blanket of fog shrouded Foxborough and its first playoff game in 18 years. The surreal setting, however, did little to dampen New England's enthusiasm. The poor visibility even gave one player a feeling of invincibility.
My pastor's wife, she said, "Let's just pray that God would blind them so they can't see you." So I went out there and I seen this fog and I'm like, wow, you know, and it just like made me more enthused. You know, it was just like, they're really not gonna see me when I'm running today.
The Steelers certainly seemed sightless as New England shrugged off the conditions with a spectral spiral.
Down going long and deep, down the right sideline, caught. Terry Glenn inside the 10 to the 5, to the 2, first and goal.
Terry Glenn's 53-yard catch set up a 2-yard Curtis Martin score. And then on the Patriots' next possession, Keith Byers made a ghostly gallop to the end zone from 34 yards out. Although they led 14 to nothing, the Patriots couldn't feel secure until the defense put up some roadblocks.
The bus stops here! The bus stops here! The bus stops here!
Set!
The Steelers' offense ground to a halt as the Patriots bruised and battered the defending AFC champions. New England was proving to be a real unfriendly place to play in the postseason. The only thing Pittsburgh did see of number 28 was his back.
Pitch to Curtis Martin across the middle at the 25. At the 30, 35, he's in midfield!
When I broke out and seen myself in the open, it's almost like I can hear everyone saying, "Run, Forrest, run."
Curtis Martin breaks it all the way! 79-9, Patriot touchdown!
I don't think I ever be a part of anything like that again. Everybody was so intense. And we had never heard our crowd respond to us the way that they did in the Pittsburgh game.
The Patriots fans were a big part of one of the most emotional wins in team history. And as Martin capped off a 3-touchdown day from 23 yards out, all of New England began to celebrate. The Patriots had gone from 0-2 to hosting their conference championship.
AFC, we'll win that fight! AFC, we'll win that fight! AFC, watch us explode!
Good afternoon, and welcome to the biggest football game ever played in New England. For the first time ever, the New England Patriots hosting the American Football Conference championship game against the wild-card Jacksonville Jaguars. It's cold, it's windy, it's clear. It's a great day for football here in Foxborough.
On the road! On the road! On the road! This ain't number! This is number! On the road, baby! We're going to get back! We're going to get back!
The Patriots turned the Jaguars' early miscue into their first 7 points.
Marshall calling signal, second and goal. Hand off Curtis, left side. Touchdown, Patriots! Curtis marking a 1-yard run. And the Patriots are on the board with a game only 2.5 minutes old.
Jacksonville had been caught off guard, but keeping the upstart Jaguars in check the rest of the game wouldn't be easy. New England's defense was up to the task and held the explosive Jaguars to only 3 first-half points. On offense, however, the Patriots struggled as several promising drives were stopped short. New England did manage a field goal to lead by 7 as halftime approached, but this team seemed to have lost its momentum. To regain their edge, the Patriots needed a lift before the intermission.
Second down and 11. Bledsoe back to throw. Giving ground, looking, shooting long and deep. Jefferson got it at the 5 and down.
Sean Jefferson's 38-yard play with 8 seconds left set up Adam Vinatieri for another kick and a 10-point lead. Jacksonville managed another field goal, and late in the fourth quarter, this game became a nail-biter. The Jaguars threatened to tie the score on a second-and-goal play from the 5.
Pats lead 13-6. Brunell is back to throw. Looking, fires end zone. Intercepted by Willie Clay!
Willie Clay ended one Jacksonville drive, but with plenty of time still left on the clock, the Jaguars took possession yet again. The defense was called upon once more to save the day.
Brunell on a draw to James Stewart, coming up the middle at the 40, 45. In and down, fumble. Patriots have it. It's picked up by Otis Smith. 30, 25. He's going to go all the way. Touchdown. Otis Smith, a 47-yard fumble return.
Making the big play when it matters most is the sign of a true champion. On Jacksonville's first play of the drive, linebacker Chris Slade, number 53, knocked the ball loose. And cornerback Otis Smith grabbed the fumble, running 47 yards to fulfill the Patriots' destiny. One more defensive play, and the celebration was in full swing.
I'd like to present to Bob Kraft and his family the Lamar Hunt Trophy, emblematic of supremacy in the AFC. Our congratulations to you and the entire organization.
This is for all the fans out here who waited 37 years.
As the players thanked the fans for their support, New England's 12th man returned the gesture with the same energy and affection they had given all year long. It took a tremendous amount of hard work, a never-say-die attitude, and the dedication of every individual in the New England Patriots organization to make the story of the 1996 Patriots one of inspiration and success. The Patriots earned their conference's highest honor because they were united in one goal, bringing a championship home.
New Edge Pro Gel presents the New England Patriots' ultimate performance of 1996. In Week 14, the New England Patriots lit up the scoreboard for 45 points against the San Diego Chargers. New England's defense forced 5 Charger turnovers, including a fumble recovery in the end zone by Willie McGinnis for a touchdown. Rookie Terry Glenn's touchdown catch was one of 4 touchdown passes thrown by Patriots quarterback Drew Bledsoe. New England routed the Chargers 45-7 and would go on to represent the AFC in the Super Bowl.